how to solder and what a dry joint looks like. This was a brand new product that didn't work out of the box. Took it out of the box, had a look, and you can see here that the wire has never ever been soldered onto that joint. There's the wire, there's the joint. It was poked through the hole, and because of that you could actually see that there was a bit of solder on the wire, but there's no solder on that side of the tag. If we turn the motor around, you can see on that side there is some solder there and there. So that means the person did actually try and solder it in, it just didn't stick. And that's the problem with soldering, you have to get it right. Now, I always do it this way. I cut the, if I've got the availability, I always cut the old joint off, because you never know what it's going to be like otherwise, because it may well have half the wires cut through. At this point I'd normally give it a good twist to make sure the wires are nice and neat, but you have to be careful that you don't stick it in your fingers and things. But also, as you can see here, the wire's not particularly clean, as in it's not a nice bright copper colour, so it may not take the solder straight away. But what we're trying to do is we're trying to get it to go into that tag, which is mounted in nylon, so we don't want to be putting heat onto there. So as you can see here, this is not particularly copper coloured, and so we'll see how it actually takes on the solder. I'm not overly enthusiastic about it, but this is the way you do it. Put the just tin iron, and then put the iron up and then the solder on top, and it should flow. Now this hasn't, so what I had to do was then go away, give it a scrape and then try again. But having done that, you can then put that into the wire there. You can then put that into the tag and hopefully it should all work. Let's see how we get on then. So there it is, it's in the tag. And right, put the iron on one side, put the solder to the joint, not on the iron. You're not using the iron like a butter knife, you actually want it to be a heat source, and then you get a nice flow like that. That's the way a joint should be done, or a variation of it anyway. The most important thing when you're doing soldering is that you get a good iron, one that you can clean the tip with, and preferably that you can set the temperature on. You don't want one of the old hacking sticks. Something like this is ideal. This is the one I use. This is less than $20 from Amazon, but as you can see on here, Amazon on all the different countries have good selection of soldering irons, and so it's something that will meet every budget and every need, including that one there. So it's well worth spending a few minutes deciding which one you want, and then make sure you get something that's suitable, preferably with interchangeable tips, and then you can go from there. If you want, there's a link in the description to all the different Amazon soldering sites. Well, that's the end of that. I hope that maybe you got something out of that. If there's any questions, put them in the comments. If you'd like to subscribe, please do, and share this about, and we'll try and get the channel to grow. Thanks a lot. Catch you again. Bye-bye.